homemade pineapple pizza. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how to make an homemade pineapple pizza. It's just a simple pineapple on a pizza recipe, and it's very delicious. This is an easy recipe that you can use with ingredients that you have at home. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a pizza recipe with pineapple and a pizza recipe with carrots. It's very delicious, and also is a chicken pizza recipe. All these ingredients that are very simple and very easy to get at home. If you're interested in making this homemade pineapple pizza, please come along with me. Welcome to Olayemi Cooking Channel. If you are new here, you are welcome. For old and new subscribers, thanks so much for being supportive of my channel. I aim to give you simple and unique recipe to the best as I can share. So welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start making our perfect pizza recipe dough. I'm going to add lukewarm water in the bowl. Then I'm going to go ahead and add 2 teaspoons of sugar. Likewise, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of dry yeast, that is active yeast. You can use instant yeast as well. So I'm going to give it a nice mix. I'm going to stir it because I want my yeast to be activated and well mixed. So in that process, I'm going to go ahead and add 1/2 cup of wheat flour. I'm also using wheat flour to give it a nice taste. It's a perfect combination when you mix wheat flour with your all-purpose flour to make your pizza dough. So I'm going to go ahead and add my all-purpose flour, which is 2 cups of all-purpose flour. So I'm using 2.5 cups to make my pizza dough. So I'm going to add my flour into it, then give it a little stir. Then let me just add my pinch of salt. So I'm going to use 1/4 spoon of salt. So I'm going to add my salt into my flour, then mix everything until I get the perfect dough that I want. It's a perfect pizza dough that you are going to love. It's not too fresh, it's sticky. And I'm going to add my melted butter. I'm using 2 teaspoons of melted butter. Then I'm going to stir this as well. I'm going to mix everything until my dough and my ingredients are well cooperated. At this stage, I will mix it until I didn't find any butter in my dough. So let me just mix this. If you've not liked, please hit the like button. And this is the outcome. I just gave it a little stir. Then we are going to cover this so we can leave it for 30 minutes. You can as well leave it for an hour or 45 minutes. It all depends on the temperature of your room or where you're putting your dough. So I'm going to cover this for 30 minutes. I'm using 30 minutes to make my dough. Then I'm going to leave it for 30 minutes, as I said. Then I'm going to use my kitchen towel to cover it. So I'm going to be using 2 cloths to cover it, just to trap the heat and trap so many things, so it will rise very fast. So I'm extra cover on it. So I will leave it for 30 minutes. Now let's go to the topping of our pizza. What we'll be needing. So I'm going to be needing mozzarella cheese, and likewise I'm going to be needing spinach as well. So I have this grilled chicken, so I'm going to be using roasted chicken as well, pizza sauce, homemade pizza sauce, and likewise pineapple. You can cook your pineapple. So let's just go back to our dough. So this is 30 minutes after, and our dough is perfectly risen twice the size. So at this stage, you are going to go to the flat surface and work our dough. So I'm going to add little flour on the surface, then I'm just going to work my dough for just 5 minutes. You can as well do it 10 minutes. It all depends on how you want the perfect dough. I normally do make a mix my dough for just 5 minutes, so then we start making our pizza in our next stage. So at this stage, I'm going to just work it for just 5 minutes, just using my spatula to mix it and just work it for 5 minutes. If you've not liked, please remember to give this video a thumbs up, and please leave your question in this comment section and encourage me to do more if you hit the like button. So this is our perfect dough. Let's put it in a pizza pan. So as I said, we are going to spread it. If you've not subscribed to my channel, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button and leave all your questions in the comment section as well. share this recipe with your friend. So I'm just going to use my hand to spread this dough until you brand the pan, so the pizza pan. So this is the outcome. So remember to give us a like and remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get updated of my next recipe. So I'm going to go ahead and add my pizza sauce on the surface, just rub it to all the edges of the pizza. Not too much pizza sauce, it all depends on how you like pizza sauce on your pizza, but I don't want too much pizza sauce, so I just add a little pizza sauce to rub the surface so I can still see the surface of the pizza. Everything will still look a little bit transparent, not too red. So that is how I like my own pizza sauce on my pizza. So I'm going to add my shredded mozzarella cheese. So and then we'll go ahead and add other ingredients. So let me just add my cheese. If you have any question regarding any of my pizza recipe or any of my recipe, please leave it in the comment section, and I'll answer your question to the best of my knowledge. So my grilled chicken, my roasted chicken, I just add my roasted chicken on the surface. It really tastes good. This recipe tastes good, and that's why I'm sharing this recipe with you. Then I'm going to add my spinach as well. It's very delicious, and you know spinach is very healthy. So I'm just going to add just little spinach on the surface just to give it that nice color and nice flavor. So I just add my carrot. So I'm going to add more carrots. You can use any type of carrot, baby carrot or any carrot. I just add onions into it, and likewise I'm going to add my pineapple. You can as well cook your pineapple before you put it in your pizza, or you can just use the pineapple like that. I didn't cook mine, I just add it to the surface because I still want that flavor of that pineapple to still remain on my pizza. So that's why I'm leaving it like that. You can see how it looks. It looks beautiful and it looks inviting. So let's rub the surface with egg just to give it that nice and perfect pizza dough that after to stay baking your pizza you are going to love how it comes up. So I'm just going to rub the edges of the pizza with egg. So this is the oven. We are going to put it in the preheated oven. Our oven has been preheated. I'm going to bake it for 25 minutes. So this is the outcome after 25 minutes. You can see how our pizza looks. It looks really inviting. So let me put it on the surface so you can see how it looks. Then we start slicing our pizza. Have you subscribed to my channel yet? If not, please do not forget to hit the subscribe button to encourage me to do more delicious recipe and share more recipe with you. And do not forget to hit the notification bell as well to get more updates of my recipe. And remember to give this video a like, and remember to share with your friend. So this is it after slicing it, and do not forget to take your slice as well. So so enjoy this pizza recipe with me, and do not forget to check more of my recipe. I have so many recipe on pizza, and I also have so many recipe on how to grate beef on bus grater, and I also have so many recipe on smoothie. All this recipe will be put in the description below. You can look at it, you can see how it looks, rich with flavor, rich with filling, and this perfect look. This pizza really look delicious. If you have never tried pineapple pizza before, homemade pineapple pizza, or pineapple on pizza, if you have never tried that before, this will be an easy and simple recipe that you are going to enjoy. I really enjoy eating this. This is my first time of trying pineapple pizza, and it tastes delicious. Do not forget to check this my fried rice recipe and this smoothie recipe, and as well check this Nigeria snacks chin chin, and this is a nice recipe on carrot pizza. So it tastes delicious. Thanks so much. I will see you all next time in my next recipe, and please be safe out there. We have so many subtitles now, please do not forget to select your own subtitle.